Hi everyone. In today's video, we'll discuss section 20 of CrPc, which is the Executive Magistrate. So we find that for every district and metropolitan area, it is the duty of the state government to appoint Executive Magistrates. These Executive Magistrates are the officers of the state government for undertaking provisions which are correlating to CrPc. For example, maintaining of public peace and tranquility, section 107 of CrPc. For these provisions, we have Executive Magistrates, which although work under the aegis of the state government, at times perform quasi-judicial functions. So we have for every district and metropolitan area, the state government is to appoint an executive magistrate. Now, of all the executive magistrates appointed by the state government, one of them is to be made the district magistrate. Now, this is done on the basis of seniority, that among the cadre of executive magistrate, one of the EMs, that is the executive magistrate, is appointed as the district magistrate. Now we have subsection 2, which says that the executive state government can appoint additional district magistrate. Again, state government can appoint any executive magistrate to be additional district magistrate. So here under subsection 1, we find the provision for district magistrate. District magistrate, whereas under subsection 2, we find the provision for additional district magistrate. And such additional district magistrate will have all the powers of a district magistrate. Now coming down to subsection 4, it says that an executive magistrate in charge of a subdivision, or subsection 4 paves way for subdivisional magistrate, for any subdivision. For the meaning of subdivision, again, please refer back to the territorial divisions, section 7, section 8, what we studied in our previous videos. So I'm assuming that the concept of subdivision is clear, and therefore for any subdivision, the state government can appoint any executive magistrate to be in charge of that subdivision, and such executive magistrate will be called the subdivisional magistrate. Subsection 5 is particularly interesting here because it establishes for commissioner of police, or what we generally call the police commissioner. Now, subsection 5, that is 25, it confers judicial power on a commissioner of a police in a metropolitan area. So we have a commissioner of police will undergo certain judicial powers, such as under Immoral Traffic Prevention Act 1956. It is the commissioner of police who is in charge and confers the judicial power. With reference to district magistrate, it is important for us to understand section 22 also. Section 22 discusses local jurisdiction of executive magistrate and says that district magistrate from time to time define the local limit of areas within which executive magistrate function. So therefore, district magistrate appoint work to executive magistrates. We have a district magistrate at the top of the rung, executive magistrate just lower to it. On a quite very similar note to what we studied under section 13, as well as section 18, that is provision for establishment of special judicial magistrate of first class and special metropolitan magistrate. On a very similar note, in the executive side, we have section 21, which discusses the establishment of special executive magistrate. That is, the state government can appoint an executive magistrate to be known as special executive magistrate for any particular area for performance of particular functions, and confer on such special executive magistrate powers of an executive magistrate. Therefore, we find that special executive magistrate is entitled to exercise any of power of the executive magistrate conferred by the court. We have the provision of special executive magistrate here. In our next video, we'll discuss subordination of executive magistrate and understand the overall hierarchy with the help of a flowchart.